All right, fit people out there, I am bringing you a workout. It's going to be about 10 minutes that's going to tighten and tone pretty much all of those troubled areas, especially for the ladies. So we're going to be on the floor the whole time. So this is stuff that you can do while you're watching TV or while your kids are watching TV or, you know, first thing in the morning. It's really good to get these muscles fired up. And I'll make sure to tell you the ones that are really awesome for just providing a little more toned look to the body, like before you go out. Okay, so we're going to start on our backs. Feet are going to be about hips distance apart, maybe a little bit wider. We're going to start by squeezing the glutes, lifting them up. So shoulders are relaxed. You're going to exhale, lift up, inhale, and come down. And you're not overextending through the hip flexors. You're going to keep them long. Try to keep it flat. You have gravity on your side here, so sink the abs in. You should be able to look at your abs and be like, woo! And you just tell your abs to stay that flat the whole time. So all of these, we do a lot of repetitions here. We are not using any equipment. You don't even need a mat. Okay, that's totally up to you. But the abs are in tight. Now I want you to think about squeezing the glutes together, then lifting up. You never rest on the floor. Keep everything tight. Okay, that's the big thing. And the rep range for these, it's going to be anywhere between 20 and 40. If you suffer from shin splints, you're going to want to press through the heels on this particular move and lift the rest of your foot way up off the floor. That's going to strengthen your peroneals. So let's see, we're going to be at 20 by now, right? Make sure you're breathing the whole time. Always make sure that you warm up. So from here, we're going to move on to a modified push-up. If you're feeling big and bad, go ahead and do it from your toes. Abs are in tight, one straight line. You're coming straight down and straight up. Palm the floor. And send your elbows out to the side. And I always tell my ladies, our strength in our push-up comes from our chest. Men can use a lot of their arms. And so for my girls, you know, just get them as wide as you can, your palms, and your chest comes down right in between your palms. Okay, don't chicken neck. You aren't aiming for the floor with your neck. Couple more. Keep the abs in. Knit the rib cage together. You're doing great. Are you watching this eating pizza? I do that sometimes. All right, so from here, you're going to flip back over. Back to abs. So we're going to do a crisscross. Fingertips only behind the head. Okay, no holding hands. Lift the knees up above the hips. Take an inhale here. As you exhale, you're taking your elbow to your knee. Then to the other side. Really and truly, I don't ever let my clients go any faster than this. Because if you go faster, you're using momentum. Momentum is akin to gravity and therefore not your friend. Okay, so you can probably do 20 to 40 of these pretty easily. If this one is not working for you, you've got a back injury, keep the feet on the floor and do a modified version. Not a big deal, okay? We can work around anything you've got, trust me. All right, from here, you're gonna flip it over to all fours. And we're gonna work some more into the legs and your butt, all right? Now, aesthetically, you know, everybody wants a nice butt, but really and truly, this is where a lot of your power comes from, so even men need to work that because it's going to give you power in whatever you do. So hands are spread really, really wide, grip the ground. You're going to pull the knee in toward the chest, weights in the arms, and then you sweep the leg up and back. So you get a lot of ab right there, a lot of glute, okay? If your leg's not going as high as mine, don't worry about it. You just take it as high as it can get. And again, we're doing about 20. Today, once you get to know the routine, you just do as many as you can. Do, you know, 20 to 40 reps. You pause it. You shut me up. I do not take offense to that. But you're going to be doing one leg at a time. So when we switch moves, we're going to stay on the same leg. Make sure that the core is completely engaged. You never want to have a sloppy core when you're doing your workout. That's just not cool. Squeeze your arms together like you're trying to pop a beach ball between them. And if you need extra padding for your knee, go ahead and put that under there. Next time that the leg is back, you're just going to pulse it up. So my kneecap is facing the floor. I reach through my toes. You can always flex them if it feels better. Totally up to you. I'm a big beat girl. Abs stay in. Try to knit the rib cage and the hip together so you're constantly creating this tight little lift through the core. Four, three, two, one. Now you're going to reach the toes up to the ceiling, then you're going to press up. Lift, lower. So this gets like a little intense. And if you're not holding your core, you're going to feel your back droop. And it's going to be all in your lower back. So pull it in. Breathe, 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 breathe. And again, you know, 20 to 40 repetitions, no matter what you're doing. My clients hate this. They hate it. It's like a love-hate relationship, though. Abs, abs, abs. Keep the arms tight. Hold it up, little pulses. Lift, lift. It's those little bitty pulses that actually get a little deeper into the muscle fiber. And that's what we want to do, ultimately. This is a lot of glute. A whole lot, I can tell you that. Just keep looking down to the floor. You don't have to look at me. Ain't nothing special to look at anyways. Four, three, two, one. Now you're going to pull the knee in. Then you're going to take it out to the side. We call it a fire hydrant. So it's just a lift and a lower. And if you're working the rotation and you're pulling in, you're going to feel it in your external oblique, which is awesome because that's your waist, right? If you're pressing into the ground, you'll feel it a little bit in your back muscles, which is good as well. Try to get y'all some music today. Be careful with that. This is, by the way, I got this from Power Music. This is aerobics and strength music, so BPMs and everything. Keep a 90-degree angle in the knee. Keep the arms squeezing in. You want to work your arms the whole time. Four more. Four. Three. Two. One. Now you're going to take it out and extend. So you kick it, draw it in. Kick it, draw it in. So it's just like a little bigger range of motion. You got to use a little more abs here. You know, if you want to get a loved one to stand in front of you right there, you can. And we aren't going to pulse any of these because we got some really fun ones on the floor. Breathe, breathe. I'm going to do one side with you for the video today. So if you see me out in public and my butt cheeks are wonky, you'll know why. Ha ha. Joking. Make sure you do both sides. If I do both sides, then it's either the same jokes over and over again or it's complete silence, which is weird. Three more. Two. Last one. Nice. Now you can sit back, give a stretch, snap, crackle, pop through your spine. Then you're going to come onto your side. Okay, like you're laying at the beach. And you're going to bring your knees forward. If your neck is feeling really, really strained, there is no problem with doing this. Okay, as a matter of fact, let's all do that. Because I have yet to meet people that don't have strain in their neck. So it's like you fell out of a chair. 90 degree bend from hip to knee, from knee to ankle. Flex the feet, take a deep inhale. As you exhale, pull the abs in, knee and foot come up. Inhale, squeeze down. Exhale, take it up. Granted, this is not the most attractive move, but it's working. We're getting a little deeper into the hip itself, and that is a lot of stability that burning that you'll start to feel, that's the muscles stabilizing. Your hip rotators are all working. Abs staying super tight. Blah, 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 right? We know all of that. Make sure the abs really do stay in, because we tend to get a little lazy in the core during these. And you'll start to feel it generally like about now, probably. And it's because we've been on that leg for so long that it's kind of, you know, getting really, really tight. So keep remembering all of the abs pull up. Okay, so it's not just suck in, it's suck in, draw up. That makes it efficient. Two more. Nice. Then you can come down. You can smack it into submission. Sweet. All right, from here, tuck your heels. Point your toes. We're going to work on a clam. So you're going to open and close. Open and close. We're going to make this harder in a minute. So it's similar to the move we just did, but you want to keep your feet touching. If you want to flex the feet, you can, and just have the heels touching. It depends on where you feel it. You want this towards the base of the glute, where the glute and the hamstring meet up. That's where you want to feel it. Abdominals keep pulling in like there is no tomorrow. I always tell my class, it's like you're in your swimsuit at the beach and you have to walk in front of 100 people to go to the bathroom. What do? You brace your core, you draw everything in. And then the men in my class always go, no, I don't. So, do that, okay? It's more aesthetically pleasing and it's safer for your spine. Three more. Two more. Last one. Then you even up the shins, point through the toes. Knee to knee, toe to toe. Do it again slow. Knee to knee, toe to toe. One more slow. It's like the shin is like on a seesaw. Now we're gonna bounce it out. Boom, boom. So this one, I ain't gonna lie, it's a burner. But this is what actually helps to shape the thigh, the outside of the thigh, the inner thigh, the outside of the glute, into the hip. Okay, all of that. And in terms of health, it helps to keep the hip joint very healthy because of the movement and the strength that's found in there. So abs, abs, abs. Don't forget about them. Nice. Four, three, two, one. Oh, hallelujah. Smack it around. You're gonna come to your back, stretch that out. Okay, so the ankle comes over the knee, you got a figure four. If you want, you can simply just press the knee away and hang out here if you're a little tight in the hip. If your hip feels like it's screaming for more stretch, then you pull the left knee in, hands come around, keep drawing the left knee in, let the hips hang low, and keep pressing the right knee away from you. Keep breathing. That's the biggest thing. We always forget to breathe, and if you're me, you forget to put a pedicure, you know. So you have like weird looking toes. All right. See, fitness can be fun. Okay. When you're done, you're gonna take your legs up towards the sky, and you're gonna shake, 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 shake. Easy enough. We're gonna finish off the abs. So glue the legs together. Yes, we're gonna do this before you move on to the next one. So we're going to glue them. You can't see my feet in that, but I've got them flexed like that. If your legs don't go straight, soft bend, no big deal. Hands behind the head. You're going to crunch up and down. Try to keep the tailbone where it is. Now, this is totally fine if you want to stay here. That's okay. If you want to take it a little bit harder, you're going to drop the leg as you crunch up. So it's going to feel really awkward, because you're kind of going the opposite of what you think you should go. But trust me, it's gonna work. It works for coordination too. Suck the abs in really, really tight. Four more. Four, three, two, and one. Now with the abs tight and the knees can bend, you're gonna straighten the legs out. Squeeze everything you've got from your rib cage all the way down. Fingertips behind the head, chin off the chest, crunch up, take it down. Curve your abdominals inward, make them very flat, okay? Get them to do your bidding. Squeeze your inner thighs together, please, please, please keep a light grip on your skull, okay? My fingers are like this on my skull. I press my fingers into my skull. That protects my neck. And my elbows too, really wide. If you would finish off all of your exercises with 50 to 100 of these straight-legged crunches, you get a flatness to the abs, you know? Everybody always wants flat abs. But, you know, when you tell people you work out, that's the first thing they look at, right, is your stomach. They're like, oh, really? So this is how you get it. Abs are in, abs are in, abs are in. Two more. One more. Nice! From here, just kind of stretch it out. You can roll the knees around, you know. And then what you're going to do to finish that off is you're actually going to go back to the beginning. So back to the beginning of the video, start with your bridges, do your abs, and then come back to the other leg. So whatever leg you weren't doing, you're going to do again. That's going to give you a killer 10, maybe 15 minute workout, depending on how many reps you do. Obviously, the more reps, the longer it's going to take. And then make sure that you always stretch it out afterwards so that you promote a long, lean look to the body. And that also aids in muscle recovery. Make sure that you are eating for the body that you want. Eat lean, eat clean, and be back here for some more exercises. Thanks, and have a healthy day.